Greetings, couch potatoes. This is Dude Long Couch. Welcome back to Metal Gear Solid 5, the Fan of Pein. Oh boy, do I ever not remember what was going on in this game. Alright, let's go in here and accept our rewards first. Yay, combat unit leveled up. Fantastic. So, the last video I did in the series was for the Metal Gear Online component. You may have seen it. If you didn't, that's quite alright. But I've been doing pretty much nothing but that for the last couple days, so I kind of forgot where we were in the main story. Let me just get my bearings here. Why am I coming in here? I have no reason to do that right now. My base is full up. I got no room for anybody. The only thing I can construct is a support platform, which is lame. Not gonna do that right now. Let's see if we got any cool things to make. Specify a project. Oh man, I got some mad GMP. Actually, hold on a second. Before we go through that, that reminds me. It's always smart to go in here and do this first. 400,000? Fuck, yes! And a rifle blueprint? Dude, we're doing this right the hell now. And it's gonna be our A-plus crew, because they're the only ones good enough to do it and not get murdered. That's not nearly as much GMP as I thought it was. 859,000, that's not a... not a terribly small amount, but it's not what I used to have back when I was a high roller. I've just been spending this stuff like crazy. But we should be able to build a few things with what we got now, if we want to. I think probably my biggest complaint about this game so far, guys, is that there's no way for me to know which of these guns I want and which ones I don't. The stat comparisons, I'm glad that they're there, but they're not like super duper helpful. I'd love to be able to actually go into like a training mode and just try them out, actually get like the feel of them. These look pretty badass here. The Asando is supposed to be a good grenade launcher. I've been using the big ass one. Is there an upgrade for that? Not the Grom, this guy right here. Stopping power goes up. See, it says it's customized to fire special warheads. I haven't seen anything like that though. I don't know how to develop special warheads for it. But just going off of what I've heard from comments and things like that, the Asando is kind of the way to go. And this looks like this upgrade is pretty damn nice for it. Oh, man. And the Hail MGR magazine loading grenade launcher. That just looks cool. I never know what to do, guys. I'll tell you one thing. I definitely want... I want to try these active decoys. That sounds like it'd be pretty useful for sneaking missions, and just fun to play around with in general. LLG mines... I mean, I love the sleep gas, but in grenade form, I feel like it's kind of the way to go with those. This sounds like it'd be super useful, especially on that... That's right, that mission that we played last time, where I was trying to extract that vehicle with the cargo on it, and it had the escort of tanks. Man, this would have been helpful for that. But, if we just did a mission like that, we might not need something like that again for a while. Stun arm, no. Active sonar, too. I never used the level 1, so it's kind of like, who cares about that? Anti-tank mines. Large mine powerful enough to destroy armored vehicles. See, I don't want to destroy this stuff, though. The whole, like, Fulton recovery thing really changes the way I go about missions like the ones in this game. Like, normally I'd be all about, like, yeah, let's cause as much destruction as possible. It'll be, like, just cause. Let's go in there and just blow the hell out of everything. But I don't want to do that. I don't want to blow up anything. I want to bring it all back to my base and sell it. So I guess we'll just... Please select a mission. We'll just stick with what we got for now. Let's see. Mission 17, rescue the intel agents. Let's hear the briefing tape.
Boss, this is an emergency. We had two intel team agents undercover at the PF Contract Forces of Africa. The CFA have captured them both. They don't have long to live. You've got to get them out of there ASAP. Since our mission at the oil field, we're no longer just business rivals to the CFA. We're enemies, and they want revenge. Our men will be killed the moment the interrogation's complete. And then it won't just be a matter of two dead soldiers. Their execution will be a catalyst, sparking resentment within Diamond Dogs against the CFA. Our men will push us to retaliate. Then things will cease to be about business. We'll be starting a personal war. That's not what we set out to do. The two men are being held in Kaziba camp. Hurry, boss. They're counting on you. Don't let them down.
Man, Kaziba camp seems to be a place that has a lot of stuff going on. I feel like we always come back to that area. So this is the one that I'm assuming there's going to be a pretty serious time limit on this, the way Kaz talks about it. Do we want to risk jumping straight in there? I mean, these danger high landing zones, they don't seem all that dangerous. Like, usually you can get in and let your chopper get away and it's fine, but you're starting out on an alert status. There's no way to do that stealthily, as far as I know. So I think we'd be better served landing over here and just fucking hightailing it.
Heading to Central Africa.
In fact, I think I will probably bring D-Walker for this mission, just so I can get there quickly. And then once I get there, well, maybe instead of that, maybe I'll deploy with a vehicle. Because we can do that now. I could bring a tank in. I forgot I extracted these tanks. Oh, that would be badass. But no, that's probably not a smart thing to do. Which one's faster? This one is a little faster. It's the fastest one I got, so we'll take this guy. And... I think I want to try to be stealthy on this one, so... we will take this. This doesn't have a silencer with it yet, does it? Maybe I'll take this instead. I don't want to kill a ton of guys, but I also don't want to give myself away. And I think everything else should be good. Actually, instead of taking the battle dress, let's bring something a little bit more sneaky. We'll take the woodland, since we're going to be in the woods. I hope this is like the best option for like the jungle scenario. Do we want the scarf? I don't really know what kind of tactical advantage that gives you, but it looks badass, so we'll take it. Alright, hopefully this is the correct loadout for this mission. We're going to find out. Here we go. And we will go in during the day. Actually, no. Eh. These guys have been pretty pimped out. If I go in at night, they're probably just gonna have night vision goggles. Deploying. We'll go in during the day, that way I can actually try to blend in. My camo might actually do me some good. I gotta be honest with you guys, I've been trying to play the Metal Gear Online portion pretty much nonstop. And, if you guys watched that video, you saw that at the end, the servers were really having some problems, and it kind of feels like it's actually gotten a little worse since that video. Like, once you get into a game, it's all good, but it's actually been really hard to even get into a game at all. Episode 17, Rescue the Intel Agents.
Two of our Intel team members are being held captive by the PF in that area. The CFA. Your job is to rescue them. They don't have long to live. It appears that one of our two men has broken out of the encampment and is on the run.
Oh shit.
He contacted us to say he was surrounded. That's the last we heard from him. Your map is marked with a predicted field of movement based on where his transmissions cut off. The other man is still captive inside the encampment. Boss, rescue our men. Extract them both and get them back to Mother Base.
Oh, it's already getting complicated. Alright, so somebody broke out and is on the run. That looks like the camp over there. So the guy on the run is probably over in that direction.
Be careful down there, boss.
Where's my vehicle? There it is. Come on, Dee Dee. There's no time to waste. Next time I think about it, I'm gonna change the chopper music too, just so we have a little variation. Alright, so he said he was surrounded. Dee Dee should let me know when I get close to somebody. Oh, that tree is no more. Big boss is not one with nature. Fuck a tree. Okay. I was completely wrong. This is the camp. I was looking at the outpost over there. That was my problem. All right, we should probably go help this guy out first.
Enemy presence did Tamaga play. The map has been updated.
I think he's probably in a bit of a more dire situation. Question is, can I sneak right through here without pissing anybody off? All right, let's disembark. Send this guy home.
Gazeba camp, an enemy outpost. It's got good visibility and not many places to hide. Use the landscape wherever possible. Our staff member on the run last contacted us from that forest. The enemy PF already has troops spread out in a manhunt to find him.
Analysis complete.
Wow, that guy's got some skills.
Search team can find him. Check his location on your iDroid.
Well, I mean, this is where he's predicted to be. I just gotta actually get eyes on him.
Analysis complete.
Alright, I should probably... Oh, shit! There he is! He's keeping a low profile. That's good. You just stay right there, buddy.
You have arrived at your destination.
Okay.
You've reached the target's predicted field of movement. If he's gone to ground, he'll have hidden himself somewhere in that area. Find him.
I don't know if this camo is really doing me any favors right now.
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
Come on, lose me. Lose me. Dee Dee, keep him busy.
Stop him.
Too late, never mind. Shit, I can't see his face. There we go. That was too close.
You have arrived at your destination.
It's possible that this is not the correct camo for this situation. This environment. Because this is straight up not working for me. Oh man, they're really close to him. He has a fucking helmet on. This isn't even gonna knock him out. Shit. It doesn't matter how many times I shoot him, it's not gonna help. Oh my god! Okay, I didn't know if, like...
Snake?
Great. Yep. I didn't know if, like, maybe shooting him a bunch of times would, like, override the helmet. That is not the case at all.
Find our two intel team members and rescue them from the enemy PF. We need to get both of them back safe and sound. I sent VIs of the targets to your iDroid. Take a good look.
Alright, at least now I know a little bit more what I'm actually walking into, though. So... Ah, oh, goddammit. Get up there! Alright, so who's this guy? This isn't my guy, is it? It's just a third prisoner? Huh. Interesting.
Our staff member on the run last contacted us from that forest. The enemy PF already has troops spread out in a manhunt to find him. Keep your eyes open.
That's cool.
Extract our man before their search team can find him. Check his location on your iDroid.
All right. I gotta take out as many of these guys as I can.
You've reached the target's predicted field of movement.
If he's gone to ground, he'll have hidden himself somewhere in that area. Find him.
Alright, takes care of him. I don't really care about securing them right now. I just don't want them to get back up before I can extract this guy. Getting closer. Bro.
Extraction.
You're coming with me.
Alright, that's the target. Quickly, extract them while you can.
Development project has been added.
Boss, other men. It's here. I never told them.
Enemy presence detected.
Good man.
Map has been updated.
Shit.
I swallowed.
He swallowed it, he says. Okay, we should be good to extract this guy now. You did good, soldier. Go home and rest. I'll take care of the rest from here. That went way the fuck better than the first time, guys.
Analysis complete.
Is that a sniper? Damn it.
Kojima camp, an enemy outpost. It's got good visibility and not many places to hide. Use the landscape wherever possible. Boss, a man you extracted gave us all the intel he could. We got a lead on what's happening in CFA. Check it on your iDroid.
Clouds approaching.
So this is an example. Fuck.
Sniper. Stay low and crawl along the ground.
Are you kidding me? It's like I'm not even wearing camo. Oh, this is bullshit. So this is a good example of how, like, I've been keeping up on those combat deployments and trying to reduce their equipment as much as I can. And they're still completely pimped out. It almost seems like it doesn't matter how often you do those deployments. They just constantly have what they need. Constantly. That fucking sniper. He ruined everything. Alright. You guys drove me to this. I wasn't gonna do it this way. There's a dude way over there. Nah, I'm not gonna worry about him right now. This camo fucking sucks too. Like, it feels like I'm not even wearing it right now. Like, I should have just stuck with the battle dress. Right, at least I lost him easily enough. I still don't know where the prisoner is, though. And if I wait too long, they're just gonna straight up murder him. There's my exit strategy right there. It's those two things. Alright, that guy, he's an A in R&D. That's okay, though. I don't plan on being super nice to these guys. I don't have the luxury of it.
Analysis complete.
If I run into an A-plus guy, I'll definitely try to extract him. But other than that,
analysis complete.
I'm not going to worry about it complete. Too much. Okay, that guy needs extracted. Definitely.
Analysis complete. Marker placed.
Damn, I can't see that guy's skills. I know I can get rid of this guy, though. See ya. Alright, let's knock this guy out. Wait, is he wearing a helmet? Oh, he is. Well, it's just a gas mask. I think I can still knock him out with this. Yeah. Ah, shit. No, get it out. Get the gun out, you fucker. Fuck your helmet. God damn it. Oh, it was a shield, not a helmet. Okay. That's all right.
Analysis complete.
He's an A, and he's got a skill. Whatever, I'll take him.
Analysis complete.
Yep.
Analysis complete.
Oh, nice. Very good. Okay. Doesn't appear to be anybody else around. The rest of this should be a piece of cake.
The squad is on its way to Kojima camp.
Oh shit.
We've ID'd them as some CFA heavyweights. These aren't your everyday reinforcements. Whatever's about to happen, you need to get the target out now.
Alright, I hear you. Stop screwing around. Let me just take this guy. Fuck! Oh, come on. Oh, nice, got him. That was the last shot that was gonna do it. It was the last chance I had. Okay. How the hell do I get to this guy? He's like underground somewhere.
He's coming too. Roger that.
This is problematic. I have no idea how to actually reach this guy. Can I... Oh! There we go.
That's him.
That's the target. He's injured. Looks half-starved, too.
Alright.
There's no way he can stand the shock of a Fulton extraction.
Of course not.
Get him out by chopper.
Okay.
Requested.
I'm surprised it's actually letting it land this close. I hope that that doesn't cause me problems.
Gibson, you think we're angry? The poor bastards from Massa Village will...
Analysis complete.
Oh, there's another really skilled guy.
Analysis complete.
Alright, I'll get this guy out of here and then I'll see how many guys I can extract without getting murdered.
Complete.
In the meantime, let's give these guys something to play with.
This is B-Quad. Arriving shortly at LZ.
I guess the chopper's gonna distract them better. Get out of here, P-Quad! Awesome, we did it. Just go, Pequod. I'm not coming with you right now. They're gonna make me come, aren't they? God damn it. Hold on, I at least want this guy. So much for my silencer. I love how you can hear the music slowing down while you're doing that too. That's awesome. Ah, screw that guy. Screw that guy. Damn it. Is there a way to tell the chopper to just fucking go? Oh, he's hurting. Okay. Alright. Enough screwing around. Let's go. Let's get out of here. I'll give you cover fire. Stop shooting my chopper, bastards! Yeah! Oh, I didn't get the materials. Damn it! I really wanted to do that. I forgot about them.
Nice work.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
I do wonder, so if you were to go and extract those materials and leave on them, would the chopper just follow you? Yeah, B rank. B for bite my ass. Oh my god, 8.3% accuracy. Yikes, that's rough. So overall, that mission was actually pretty short and relatively simple compared to some of the more recent ones we've done lately. I'm kind of surprised. I failed that first one because I was just kind of like, you know, I just kind of ran in and was getting a feel for it. But after that, it actually wasn't that bad. And some of that might have had to do with the fact that I decided to just be really lethal and just murder those guys, which I don't normally do, but, you know, I feel like the difficulty is starting to spike a little bit, so. Cypher's cargo. Oh, interesting. Give me my soldiers. Meta materials. Nice. Counselor. Diplomat. Got plenty of those. Alright, so we're reaching a point in the game where there's a lot of A-plus rank guys, but that's, honestly, that's like middle of the road. We got A++, S, S+, and S++ are the cream of the crop. So at this point, I'm probably only going to be taking A-rank guys and above. I think the fact that that's like demarcated with like the gold yellowish color is kind of indicative. Like, hey, once you start seeing these are really the only ones you should bother with. Everyone else is a scrub. D-Dog is a tech buddy who supports your infiltrations. Okay. Wait command to have him stay. Bark command, get the attention. Yeah, see there it says, if D-Dog is in the naked loadout, you can use the keep him busy command to have him bite an enemy. I don't understand why he can't do that all the time. I think that's stupid.
One of the job offers we received concerns me.
Mission list
There's a
updated.
PS commander who's been talking big about getting into the nuclear arms trade. This could be connected to that yellow cake.
Yellow cake?
And there's another contract I'd like you to handle. It's a wet job, but we need to divert Cypher's attention. Check the mission list for the details.
Please select a mission.
Alright, so we got two more main missions, Blood Runs Deep and On the Trail. Did we get anything new as far as side ops? No, so far we've only had two important side ops. We completed both of them. So here's what's left in Afghanistan. I went through and did like two or three, maybe a couple more of these off camera, and they still just keep throwing them on there. Like, look at the amount of side ops on this damn map. It's just, I mean, I guess a lot of them are done already, but there's still a lot more that haven't been done yet, and these are just the Afghanistan ones. Actually, you know what? I kind of want to go do this one right now. I want that legendary gunsmith. Let's move to that location. And we'll drop in right here.
Heading to Afghanistan.
That guy is mine. And we'll just keep everything current. Actually, let's pal around with Quiet for a little bit. It's been a little while since I used her. She can keep her guilty butterfly. We don't need a vehicle for this. Take it off. Wait, none. And that should be pretty good.
Deploying.
I didn't really plan on doing this in this video, but since that mission went pretty quick, we'll just go ahead and throw this one in. This one should be relatively quick too, unless it goes horribly, horribly wrong, which it could. Oh, I should have equipped my active decoys. I forgot that they were done. That's okay. I shouldn't need him for this. And this is probably the wrong camo for this environment, but you know what? It felt like I wasn't even wearing camo in that last mission. So, Maybe that's because they were pretty much already on alert because they were looking for those prisoners. That might have something to do with it. Hard to say, actually.
Be careful down there, boss.
Don't tell me what to do, Pequod. I'm pissed that I couldn't tell him to leave in the last mission. I wanted to extract more of those guys. But he was just like... just standing there waiting for me. Alright, quiet. Go scout that place out. Scout. There we go. Oh, and before I forget, let's go and do our combat deployments. Please really gotta keep up on these. Wait, look at all this shit. All this equipment just pops up again. I had this list almost completely gutted. And now they've got flashlights, they've got shields, they've got body armor, fucking machine guns, shotguns, night vision goggles. It doesn't matter how many times you do these. They just always have all this shit all the time. And it drives me insane. But you do get money for doing these too, so it's not a complete waste. But you don't get as much money as you get for some of the other ones. Like this one and this one. So... I will go ahead and send out Bravo Crew on this one.
Unit dispatched.
And let's go find us a legendary gunsmith. And actually, this is probably a really good opportunity to listen to some more cassette tapes. I picked the wrong thing.
Please select a mission.
I want to listen to the rest of the Huey interrogation. I think there's two tapes for that. We only heard the first one so far. Let's hear the rest of these.
You know the hardest man to break. The type who's fooling himself. That takes time. It's easier to live a convenient lie than a painful truth. Is that the piece you've chosen, Doc?
I'm not lying.
Of course. Just let me check one or two things. On that day, you were in the control tower with them. Lucky you. That's how you got out unscathed. And you escaped on one of their choppers. Only you, right before the base went under.
They had me blindfolded the whole time. I've never been so scared. The whole flight, I thought they'd kill me. But thinking of you kept me going. My comrades, all the way.
And?
There was a plane journey, then we traveled by road. When they finally took off the blindfold, I was in kind of a warehouse, on the floor. Afghanistan, it was that research lab. I couldn't believe they'd taken me halfway around the world. And soon enough, he came.
Skullface.
He's the one who's really behind that mother base attack. He forced me into that research.
What kind of research?
He told me to build a bipedal walking tank for the Soviet Union. Like Peace Walker. A system that could fire an ICBM-class nuclear weapon. That's how the Sahelanthropus project got started.
Sahelanthropus.
Those AI weapons I'd made in Costa Rica were like toys by comparison. A whole world apart from reptilian four-legged crawling and that ridiculous hunched-over bipedal waddling. My design evolved to the dawn of mankind. Sahelanthropus, the first steps towards humanity. An upright bipedal weapon system. Originally, Sahelanthropus was going to be a manned weapons platform. I designed a cockpit in its head, and I planned to fill it with water as a buffering agent.
Like how Puss modified Zeke for human control.
Don't compare me to some amateur. I designed it for human control from the beginning. The problem was miniaturizing the posture control AI. You remember the reptile pod?
The AI that controlled your unmanned weapons.
Attaching it externally makes it vulnerable. So this time I wanted it beneath the armor. Meaning I had to make the AI smaller. I got it down to less than a tenth the size without any loss in computation speed. But it was still too big for the cockpit. There wasn't enough room for the pilot. If I made the head bigger, its body would have to be bigger to support it. Too big to be practical. In the end, human piloting was taken off the table. I tested a remote control system, too, but there was the time lag, and I wasn't satisfied with its precision either. Plus, it would be useless if the enemy jammed it. So next, I went back to trying an AI-only system. To do that, I had the AI pods recovered from Nicaragua. This was a hybrid AI, a combination of Peace Walker's reptile and mammal pods, the only AIs that had ever successfully operated an unmanned nuclear weapon system.
Really? You'd need some help to get that working. Expert help.
Did you work with someone?
I worked alone.
You did that yourself?
That's the thing. The AI didn't pan out in the end either. But I did finally get Sahelanthropus walking by folding over its upper body to lower its center of gravity. The first upright bipedal locomotive weapon system in the history of mankind. I guess, technically, it falls into the anthropoid ape category.
I don't see the benefit of having it stand taller.
On terrain with significant differences...
Hi!
Like Afghanistan, you need a body that's vertically adaptable. That also lets it attack from long range while using mountain ridges for cover. So, making it walk upright was the most important factor.
Boss, that's a serious injury. It won't heal on its own. You'll need to treat it with first aid.
That was the whole point of Sahelanthropus. But I was being pushed for results. Having the AI mounted externally would have been the fastest way to get it working. I just needed more data so it could maintain its balance. But Skullface refused to wait. He dismissed the idea of AI control and took Sahelanthropus away from me before I could finish it.
But it was walking when it came after you.
That's just it. I don't understand how Skullface got it to move upright. Without a pilot or an AI. And walking at that speed, too. It's beyond anything I could have imagined.
Okay, subject is in.
The Wright brothers making it to the moon. I'm just...
He's coming, too. Roger that.
See this Sahelanthropus. Where is it now?
I have no idea. All my experiments took place at that cave. I've never seen it anywhere else. Besides, it's still just an incomplete prototype at this point.
You gonna extract him?
Tiger. Even if it can walk, it's far from being a viable weapons platform. It wouldn't be useful in actual battle.
Emmerich will remain here at Mother Base for now, but not as a member of Diamond Dogs. I still don't trust him. That work for you?
Fine by me. He can't be allowed any contact with staff either.
Yeah. A lot of the guys would love some payback for 9 years ago. We still need him alive. But we have to restrict his movements. He can only go where we tell him. And of course, the interrogations will continue. He worked for that skull bastard for nearly a decade. He still has more to tell us.
How long are we gonna press him?
If our investigation shows he really had nothing to do with the attack, we'll reconsider his place here. But I don't expect that to happen. Remember that water tank-shaped object in Emmerich's lab in the Soviet base camp? The thing that started talking to you like a possessed answering machine. That was a pod built for housing the AI used to control unmanned weapons. You remember, back in 74 in Costa Rica. It was in those machines you fought there. They were
destroyed. Destroyed their anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, but that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now.
Thank you.
Designate a landing zone near the
God damn it.
Autonomous behavior. But the Basilisk, aka Peace Walker, also featured a second AI pod. That one was called the Mammal Pod, and it was created by Dr. Strangelove. She tried to recreate the boss's personality through the Mammal Pod, but you pulled out its memory boards. That's when it transferred its own functions to its reptile pod. Just like a human brain compensating for damage by using the remaining healthy parts. The result was a unique entity, a hybrid of the reptile and the mammal. It sank to the bottom of Lake Nicaragua with Peace Walker. But apparently they salvaged it and transported it to that lab. Don't let it deceive you, Snake. It may sound like the boss, but it has neither a personality nor a will. Like Emmerich says, it's just a machine.
Holy shamoly, get out of here before the thing. Yeah! Did you guys see that guy? He was fucking awesome.
Subject on board.
And he's all mine now. Alright, so a truck kind of came up behind me and was like, hey, what are you doing here? We should all shoot this guy. But it all turned out alright in the end. Quiet actually did some work on these guys, so it was kind of cool. And, everything went better than expected. I almost died, but whatever. It's really, really annoying how every time you blow up one of those, anti-air things, Miller has to give his whole speech. Like, do you not realize I'm listening to a tape? I want to hear what the fucking tape says. I don't need to hear you talk about how anti-air radars open up holes for your chopper for, like, the 8 millionth time. Like, I get it. Ugh. But whatever. It's a minor gripe in a game that is full of awesomeness. So, D-Dog and Quiet are both really, really good, like, in their own ways. I like that she, like, automatically put that guy to sleep and just kind of, like, cleared up a lot of these dudes once I went into, like, an alert status. In that way, she is, like, much more powerful than D-Dog. They each have, you know, their own strengths, but I'm gonna leave her to fend for herself, because as soon as the sandstorm's over, I'm faultening away on this thing. I'm done in this area. I don't know if getting that gunsmith will open up anything for me, but I should very much like to see. Is there anybody else like that guy that was on the roof? Because goddamn, it looked like his combat skill was like even better than A++. Like, I couldn't even read it because that's how good it was. But all right, these guys are pissed off. I'm done here. I'm leaving. Quiet, you'll be fine, right? You can fend for yourself.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
I mean, something should level up from that guy. Like, wow, really? Nothing leveled up? That's crazy.
All right. List updated.
Boss, about the prisoner you extracted from the central base camp. It seems that he's not the legendary gunsmith either.
Oh, come on.
One of his apprentices. Now I'm really dying to meet this guy. We got intel on his location from the apprentice. Think you can recover him? I've added the details to your side ops list.
You guys are killing me. I am literally dying. I am literally, literally dying. It's a side op. Where is the motherfucker? The game knows, too. Look, extract the legendary gunsmith. Extract the legendary gunsmith again. Extract the legendary gunsmith yet again. He's also in Afghanistan in Yako Obu Supply Outpost. Alright. I didn't think we were going to go back to that oil field again. That's kind of cool that, wait, was that the oil field that we were just in? Central Base Camp. Is that the place where we got, that's not the oil field, what am I thinking? It's the place where we got, Emmerich the first time, I think. I was wondering when we were going to get back to that place. It was a pretty big area, and we haven't really done much in it. So I hope we go back there in the story, too. Alright, guys, next video, I'll probably do this, because I really want to finish out this quest line and get that gunsmith. I have a feeling it's going to open up something really cool for going through all this bullshit. Hopefully it's the last one in this line. If it's not, then, you know, we'll go from there. And then with any time left, we'll just get back to the main missions. I'm probably not going to show any more side ops, unless it's like an important one or something really unique or different. But you can see on this list here, it's all the same bullshit that you've seen already. It's not really anything new going on. Besides the legendary gunsmith, I'll show you that stuff. Other than that, it's going to be main missions and anything else interesting. Yeah, this game's awesome. I'm loving it. I'm loving every second of it. I don't think I'll do any more Metal Gear Online videos. Maybe as like a separate series or something. It felt kind of weird inserting that into like the main single player playlist. I know it's kind of unorthodox, but you know what? I'm an unorthodox guy. That's just how I roll. I don't give a shit what the standard is. I'm gonna make my Let's Plays the way I want to make them, and I wanted to do at least one video for that. If there's a lot of requests for more, then maybe I'll do like a separate series for the online play, but that aside, it's probably going to be the only one I do for the main Let's Play. Anyway, guys, I'm done yakking your ear off. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Dude Long Couch. Come back for the next parts, and I'll see you then. Later, guys.